Hello friends, in this video we will look at another problem that is solved using dynamic programming approach, and that is optimal binary search tree. If you are not clear about what is dynamic programming, I will be briefly covering what is the principle behind dynamic programming. And in order to watch this video, you don't need to have any prior knowledge of any other concept which is related to algorithms. I mean, you don't need to watch any other video. So I will be covering it from the scratch, what is dynamic programming and how it is useful in solving the optimal binary search tree. So let us begin. So the problem in hand is the optimum binary search tree. So first of all, we will understand what is optimal binary search tree. Then we will discuss the role of dynamic programming and why we need dynamic programming to solve this particular problem. So first, let us understand what is a optimum binary search tree. So first of all, we have to be clear. We have to revise in our mind that what is a binary search tree. So binary search tree is a tree in which there is a root R, there is a left child of the root, there is a right child of the root. Say the root is A and the left child is B and the right child is C. Then the property that B is less than A and A is less than C must be true for all the nodes in the tree. That means always the left child of a node will be smaller and always the right child of the tree node will be larger. So if we take a string of numbers, say we have 1, 2, 7, 5, 6, 4, 3. Suppose I have these numbers from 1 to 7 which are not given in a proper order. And I will want to put them on the binary tree. So first of all, binary search tree. So first node is 1 because that is the order in which I have received. Now when 2 will come, I will store it as the right child of 1. Now I receive 7. 7 is larger than 2. So I put it as the right child of 2. Then I receive 5. Now 5 is larger than 1, larger than 2, but smaller than 7. So I will put it as the left child of 7. Then I receive 6. Now it is larger than 1, larger than 2, smaller than 7. So it will go to the left, but larger than 5. So it will be stored here as the right child. And then I have 4. So when I compare it with 7, 1, 2, it is larger, 7 smaller. So 4 is smaller than 5 as well. So it will be stored as the left child of 5. And then 3 will arrive and it will come down to this position and it is smaller than 4. So 3 will be stored here. So as we can see here, the nodes are stored according to the point that whether they are smaller or larger than the root that is being considered. So this is one representation of the binary search tree which represents the numbers from 1 to 7. Now there are other representations also, like I can represent it like this with 7 at the top, and then I can put the left and the right child. So suppose I put the left child as 4. So all the elements larger than 4, that is 5 and 6, will become its right children. And then all the elements smaller, so I have 3, 2 and 1. So I put 2 in the root and I put 1 here and 3 here. So I have covered all the numbers, 1, 2, 3. And then 5, 6 and 7. So I have all the numbers from 1 to 7. Now this is one representation. I could have either as well as done this, that I put the 4 in the root and then I put 6 here, then I put the node 5 here, 7 as the right child, and then here I put 3 and 2 and 1 as its children. So 1 here and 2 here. So this is also a binary search tree representation where the left child is small and the right child is large. So like this, for 7 nodes I have n number of representations, and if you want to find out the exact formula, then that is known as the Catalan number. Catalan number is there, which is a formula from combination and permutation, and therefore for these 7 nodes I can have multiple representations. Now the problem of optimum binary search tree is to find a representation such that the tree that we select is the optimum. Now how do we define optimum? While we perform the search in this tree and we represent the tree using one of the methods, with each node there is a probability of successful search and there is a probability of failure. Now what is this probability of successful search? Probability of successful search is, if someone is looking for a 4 and he will find a 4, there is a probability which is calculated using the success rates which are there in the number of times successful search has been performed. Based on that and how many times that number was searched, based on that the probability P, that is the probability of success, is calculated. So there is a probability of success for 4, for 6, for 7, 5, 2, 1 and 3. For each of these nodes there is a probability P, P of I, which represents the probability of success. Similarly, there is a probability of failure. Now what is this probability of failure? It is represented by Q of I, and it represents the chances when we are going to fail looking for a particular number. So where are the points of failures here? If we find an item here, and if we find an item here, and we try to find an item here also, and we don't find that item on this branch, there is no chance that that item will be in the remaining tree, because according to the less than and greater than condition, we will always land here. So there are two possible points of failure here. There is a point Q0 and there is a point Q1. Now this point Q0 is that the item was less than 1 and we couldn't find it. And this point Q1 is the item was, I made a mistake here. This is 2 and this is 1, 3. Okay. So the item was less than 1 and we couldn't find it, that is Q0, and item was between 1 and 2, then the point of failure will be Q1. Similarly, if the item is between 2 and 3, then the point of failure will be Q2. And if the item will be larger than 3 but smaller than 4, then the point of failure will be Q4. Similarly, we have 2 points of failure here and 2 points of failure here. So always we will have Q values 1 more than the number of P. So if we have 7 nodes, we will have 7 values of P, but we will have 8 values of Q because the points of failure are going to be 8. So this way we have PIs and QIs related to the tree. Now how do we calculate the which one is going to be the optimum node? For this we are going to calculate two things. We are going to calculate Wij, then we are going to calculate C of ij, and we are going to calculate R of ij. So we will make a table, and in that we are going to calculate R of ij, C of ij and W of ij. What is W of ij? So I is the originating node, J is the landing node, and therefore if I am calculating W01, that means I am going to add all the P of I's from the number I to the number J. So I will start from I and I will continue till the value will reach J, and I will add all the values of P for these two which lie within this range I to J, and I am going to add all the values of Q which are going to lie between I minus 1 and J. I'm going to add all the values from I minus 1 to j. So I will add up all these values and then I will find out Ci of j, Cij. How I am going to calculate Cij? I will take an intermediate value k which will start from I and go up till j. So if I is 1 and j is 3, then k will once become 1, then 2, then 3. It will take 3 values. So this way I am going to vary k from I to j. And I am going to calculate cost of ci, k to, I will add in this, cost of k plus 1 to j. This way I am going to calculate the cost. Now these costs we are going to calculate in a table. And there we will always begin with W00 and C00. In W00 we will always have all the costs of PIs and QIs added. I will show you how to make the calculation. Then what we will put in the Rij, and then after we calculate the C1k plus C of k plus 1j, we will add Wij to this. And out of all the values for different values of k, what we are going to calculate, whatever is the minimum value, that we will preserve, others we will forget. And whatever k was minimum, gives the minimum value for Cij, that k we will store here in Rij. So this is the rank and this is the cost. And this is the weights that have been added. So I will show you how to calculate these values in the subsequent video. And these are the basics that we need to understand the optimal binary search tree. So I hope this video is useful to you and you like this video. So you can like it, subscribe it and comment on it. Thank you very much.